Hi everyone. Here I am with Ryan Jenkins. Today we're going to do a talk about NLP hypnosis and how to deal with fear and uncertainty with everything that's been going on recently. We thought this would be a useful talk to do, and that there may be something useful in this that you can apply to your to your own life and anything that may be coming up for you. So those of you who don't know, my name is Emma Bradford. I'm an NLP trainer here in Barcelona, and I've been practicing NLP for many years. And Ryan also is trained in NLP and hypnotherapy and works with hypnosis. So I'm going to hand you over to him as well. Hi, Ryan. Thanks for joining us.
Hi, Emma. So glad that we could do this today over our wonderful connection here. This is how we do everything these days. I hope everyone out there. So today we're talking about some powerful tools, some things that I know will make a real difference into your becoming more clear, more relaxed, and certainly much more calm during this particular moment. And I was saying to Emma, you know, even though we're both very practiced, very many, many years doing this professionally, I think it's useful and it's honest to say that, you know, even for us, anxiety creeps up, stress creeps up during this time. It wouldn't be honest to say otherwise, but we want to really look at the things that we know that are making the difference with regards to resilience for us and for our clients, and to make that available to you and for your use. And we're going to be speaking about different techniques, different mindset shifts. And you know, I know that if you adopt these, or if you investigate this, or you even become curious about how you're going to be using these in your life, these will have a massive impact. So I really do invite you to engage with these particular techniques and some of the ideas that we're going to be exploring here today.
Great, thank you. Yeah, absolutely. This is something that often comes up, that people say, oh, your life must be perfect now that you're an NLP trainer. And I've been doing this for many years. And yes, I feel like I have a lot more resilience, and there's many more options that open up thanks to the tools and techniques that I've learned over the years.
Oops.
Biggest things, like, this doesn't make me immune from actually feeling human emotions.
Human
emotions will pop up. And so like fear, like with everything that's been going on recently, there has been some fear coming up and thinking about what's going to happen. With everything that's like with NLP and also with hypnosis, like what it does is it helps us to tap into that inner resilience, and also helps us to transform our relationship with these emotions themselves, because they're simply an opportunity to learn more, to gain deeper insights, to get a message, to like pause, reflect, and really learn deeper layers about ourselves. So there are many gifts to be had, like looking at what comes up.
Absolutely. And you know, we're all being forced into what is essentially a retreat. So all the people that say, you know, I never have time to go into a retreat, I'd love to go on a personal development retreat. I've been waiting 5, 10 years to do this. Here's your chance. I had this insight today that there are going to be some people that really on the other side of this, because there is life after this. I think it's useful to remember that there is absolutely going to be life after this particular period in time. And the people that people that come out of this, there are going to be people that come out of this far more resilient, far more healthy, physically, mentally, and emotionally, and so much more wiser than others. And, you know, it's really up to you to decide whether that's going to be you or not.
Absolutely. I mean, as they say, like life is change. Like there are things changing in life, and even this current situation that we're in, even if it feels like, oh, we're here for how many weeks or months, depending on where we're living, that will change at some point.
Absolutely. So, yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead, Emma.
Yeah, I was just going to talk a little bit about what we were talking about before, which was about reframing and how, like, a lot in NLP and also in hypnosis is helping to shift the perspective, helping to reframe things. So what we mean by reframing is essentially changing the frame of which we are looking at something through. So it's like I could look through a very small frame at something and only see part of the picture, or I could expand that frame, like look through a bigger frame and or move the frame and see something else there. So I like to see it as I use this metaphor quite a lot, is it's like imagining that you're in a house and you're looking out of the tiny, tiny bathroom window, and you're looking out of this window and you're saying, oh, there's only a tree out there. And through like reframing, is asking ourselves questions, seeing different perspectives. So it's like we're stepping into another room in the house and we're suddenly looking out of this massive panoramic window. And then we realize, oh, actually there's a mountain, there's a river, there's like more trees. There are so many other things out there that I never even realized because I was looking out of this tiny little bathroom window. So like reframing is like that. It's like asking ourselves questions and seeing different perspectives and opening things up, expanding things, opening things up so more options become available.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. So like one very quick way to demonstrate that is imagining that we have, this is a technique that I use a lot with my students, is imagining that we have a clock projected up onto the ceiling. And that clock has a second hand and it's moving round clockwise. So if we point our finger up at that clock and we trace our finger round clockwise and we're moving our finger round clockwise and we're looking up at that clock, and at the same time what we do is we lower down our arm, our finger's still moving, just our arm is lowering down, so that we can look down on that hand and then notice which direction it's moving in now and notice what's changed. What you'll notice is that the hand is now moving anti-clockwise. The direction has shifted. Now, the actual movement of the hand has stayed the same. It's just, it seems like it's shifted because we're looking at it from a different perspective. So when we shift the perspective, when we change how we're looking at something, when we reframe something, our experience completely changes.
Absolutely. I love that example, and it's so useful as a visual demonstration of what reframing is. And it's useful to recognize that reframing is all about changing the meaning of your experience, and the meaning that you create for yourself internally is what creates your internal emotional experience around your current life circumstance. So, the author Daniel Kahneman, who wrote a book called Thinking Fast, Thinking Slow, won the Nobel Prize for his book. You know, said that human beings have these two types of thinking, two modes of mind. One is the experiencing mind. One is the storytelling mind. So the part of our mind that basically creates the narration of our life. And it's really the narration of our lives that allows us to access those resources that we have internally. Now, the problem is, most of us, that meaning is happening unconsciously. And so when you are able to consciously, or through certain modalities like NLP or hypnotherapy, hypnosis, change how those inner meanings are being made, immediately your experience changes into something that allows you to access those resources in a much more powerful way. So, you know, there are different types of reframes, but I think it's useful for us to really focus in on the ones that are pertinent, the ones that are really, really going to make the difference to our situation. And I say our because I hope you're at home and I hope you're watching this, you know, in your home and not, you know, on your mobile device out in a park somewhere. I wish I could be there with you, but now's not the time. So,
yeah.
You know?
So in terms of like reframing and seeing things from different perspectives, I mean, like one common example that we see a lot is with advertising. Like they use reframing a lot in advertising, like reframing a product and changing the meaning of it. And this comes up a lot, like, so like if we were to make it more relevant to like what's going on at the moment, like what examples, right? Do you have some examples of like current statements and things that are happening at the moment that people might say and how we can reframe those?
Well, I think it's, you know, for example, if we speak about advertising, just to people get an understanding of what a reframe is in that context. For example, there's a famous, back in the day, there was a very successful salmon, company that sold tinned salmon. And so this salmon was, because of the way that it they tinned it or something, was red, right? It was red salmon, and it was called authentic red salmon or something like this. And so their competition basically, you know, hired a advertising firm, some of them who were trained in some of these techniques, and their catch line was, because they sold pink salmon, and they would say, this is authentic pink salmon guaranteed not to turn red, which basically sets the frame that, you know, that red salmon is somehow not good. But they didn't have to say that. It just changes the meaning. So if we turn to our situation here, a very simple one is that I'm stuck at home. I'm stuck at home. And a useful reframe around that is, I get to be safe at home and spend time with my family. Just notice the difference in that.
Yeah, it's almost like one, you literally feel stuck, limited, like boxed in. Exactly. That's how I feel like when I hear that, I'm like,
exactly.
And then the other is like relaxation, gratitude, connecting to that love and which helps to counteract any fear that we might be feeling.
Right. And that those phrases, I get to, rather than I have to, right? I get to, I get to learn new ways to exercise my body that I haven't been able to while stuck in a boring old gym. I get to find new ways of cooking nutritious food with perhaps limited ingredients, you know, if you're not going out as much. I get to connect with friends from around the world that I haven't seen in a long time. I get to, you know, that very simple phrase, instead of the imperatives, I have to, I need to, I must, immediately removes that resistance, that inner resistance, which means that you'll find yourself naturally doing those things.
The language is so important. The language is really important. I mean, I'm also noticing this in news stories that are being posted everywhere on Facebook and like Instagram and online, like on the news, like there's a lot of generalization, there's a lot of deletion, and there's a lot of distortion. Oh, yeah. So by questioning things and getting clear and really paying attention to the language that's being used, we can actually help ourselves feel a lot calmer, like when we get more clear on what actually is being said.
Absolutely. Think about the thing about social distancing. We're talking about that. You know, social distancing, what does that mean? I mean, it's kind of like education. What does that mean? A politician talks about education. It's a nomination. It's a very kind of sly nominalization, but it is a nominalization. So you want to be very, very clear. What does social distancing mean? Does that mean, you know, a few meters. No, it means stay away from other people, stay home, go out once a week, and that's it. Like, it's very, very clear.
Yeah. Getting clear, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, in NLP, we say the meaning of communication is the response we get. So if people are not actually responding and doing that, and people are still going out on the beach and socializing and then the communication wasn't clear in the beginning. There needs to be a clear message of, okay, this is what we now need to do for the time being.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Yeah, absolutely. So what about, if someone's feeling too much uncertainty, if they're feeling a lot of uncertainty with everything that's going on, and they say there's too much uncertainty, because obviously like feeling safe, secure, this ties in with the human basic needs of like wanting some element of perceived certainty. Right. And when that goes over the threshold that we feel comfortable with, then this is when uncertainty and anxiety can come in. So if someone's saying too much uncertainty, like what can we say? How can we reframe that?
So there's too much uncertainty. And, you know, uncertainty is that basic, as you say, need for, we need that kind of certainty. What certainty is really control, like being able to control something that's, it's out of control, essentially, right? And what you can say is, while there may be uncertainty, there are certainly many things that are uncertain, better said, right? Because uncertainty is a nominalization as well. While there are many things that are uncertain, there are many things that are under my control that I can do to make sure I'm safe. I can wash my hands. I can stay indoors. I can do breath work. I can meditate. I can learn powerful resilience techniques. I can study the things that work. I can make changes in my business or in my work life that will allow me to work from home. I can reach out to others, you know, I can do things for myself. I can let go of those habits, for example, that are going to stop me from being healthy, for example, smoking or perhaps some other unhealthy habits that are going to get in the way of you having a strong immune system. There's so many things that are under your control. And so when you say, While there may be many things that are uncertain, there are many things that are under my control. And that immediately gives you that that clarity and that sense of psychological, but also real. It's not just psychological, it's actually being able to influence your circumstances, which means that circumstances for you physically, but also internally, will begin to change. So that has a powerful thing, a powerful influence over your life.
Absolutely. There's so much more that we have influence over, and in NLP we talk about being at cause, that we have cause and effect. So being at cause, and what that means is actually taking responsibility of what we have influence over, like what we can actually do, rather than waiting for someone or something out there to change everything magically for us. It's like, okay, what can I do? I can take some deep breaths. What can I do? I can perhaps practice some meditation or yoga. What can I do? Like coming back to being responsible, empowered human beings.
Yeah, this circumstances are not being done to you. Mm. Right? It's just something that's occurring.
It's using these situations as like a stepping stone forward. So it's like if something unexpected comes up, it's like, okay, how can I make the most of this? Like, what opportunity is being presented right now?
Yeah.
Because with every challenge, there's an opportunity there.
Absolutely. You know, I know that there are people. If you notice, I'm making sure. One of the things that you can make sure is not touch your face. And I've got an itch on my eye right now, and I'm kind of consciously going, oh, I want to scratch it. But that's something I can stop doing, you know, is touching your face, which is an unconscious thing, right? We touch our face so much. And if you look on the street, if you ever go out, you'll notice that despite the warnings, many people are still kind of touching their face and touching their, and it's one of those things that will transmit this thing. So one of the things that I'm consciously doing is being mindful of all of the times I want to touch my face. Now, obviously I've washed my hands. I haven't gone out. You know, my place is clean. It's been disinfected. It's been sort of sterilized. I've been kind of manic about it, and because that's something that I can do. And I think it's okay to have a little bit of fear. I think, you know, fearlessness in these times is not really smart, right? So if you meet anybody that says they're fearless, they're probably the ones that are out transmitting this thing. They're probably doing things that are irresponsible and going out and, you know, not being smart, you know. Have a little bit of fear. Have enough fear that will, you know, give you concern. So don't worry about it, but be concerned.
This is the thing, like the human race, like we're here thanks to fear. Like if it wasn't for fear, we wouldn't have run away from those tigers and whoever was chasing us back in the caveman days. So like, yeah. Fear is an important emotion, and it helps to protect us. It helps to guide us. It gives us little clues and insights if we listen to it and catch it in the beginning of that initial kind of, oh, something's not quite right, or oh, I need to do that just in case. Like, this is one of the things, like when we're not allowing it to flow through us, then we get stuck. It can paralyze us. So it's really important to, like, whenever we notice fear, that emotion, is to follow it up with some kind of action, loving action. So I tend to like use the question of like, what loving action can I take now? And that helps us to move through it. So we're actually doing something with that emotion. So we're acknowledging that it comes up and like, oh, thank you, fear, for pointing out how much I value that person or that thing or how I can look after myself, and I'm going to take action. I'm going to clean my house. I'm going to look after my health. I'm going to boost my immune system. I'm going to call someone and tell them I love them. I'm going to, like, there's an action there that we can take.
Yeah. So look, I touched my face again. as much as I like to not to, it happens. So your intention you know, I'm bringing that attention back. And that's so true. There's that saying that says actions speak louder than intentions. And I think, you know, if your actions are aligned, you're doing the best you can with the level of understanding, the level of awareness, to do the best you can about the things that are under your control, then there really is nothing to worry about, because there literally is nothing you can do about those things that are out of your control. So it's about opening yourself to the possibility of investigating those things that are under your ability to influence positively, and also letting go of those worries that are in a very real way imagined. Now, we're all going to get sick at some point in our life, whether it's a sniffles, whether it's a flu. And most people are worried, concerned about getting this particular bug. There's a lot of different ideas out there, and you know, I'm not going to go into, neither of us are sort of medical professionals. We're coaches. I work as a complementary healthcare professional sometimes, but you know, the fact is, listen to the science. So keep abreast of the things that are happening, but also trust your intuition. Do trust yourself, because, you know, common sense will rule in this. And common sense, real common sense, is good sense. And that'll keep you safe. And so what that means currently is staying indoors. Don't, you know, speak to anybody within, you know, a couple meters, they say. But, you know, certainly this keeping away from others, unfortunately, it's very difficult for us to do, because human relations, connection, intimate connection emotionally, is one of those human needs. And we're already starved of it. We're already quite starved of it in our modern world. So it's almost like a double tragedy that we're now being forced to isolate. But there is a beautiful thing in this. And one more reframe is that, you know, despite the physical distancing, you can become more and more emotionally connected to those around you, more and more emotionally connected to your own values and those things that are
absolutely. I've noticed a lot of creativity coming up, like that when there's some form of limitation in some way. I mean, I say limitation, it's like it's an opportunity to connect with creativity and expand the perspective. Because there's so many ways that I can see human beings all around the world getting really creative in how they connect. And this wouldn't have come about if there wasn't this change in how we have to interact at the moment. And I've certainly become creative in how I'm interacting with loved ones as well. And like playing games online and like online dance parties and you name it, it's all there.
Yeah, don't forget, we are, each and every one of us, survivors, you know. We are the current version of long lines of humanity that stretch all the way back to the dawn of mankind. We're made to survive. And you know, those that can use the best of what's happening can really look at those people also that are really, really good at resilience, really, really good at the mindsets that keep them, keep them positive, keep them optimistic, even when all hope seems lost. You know, and those can be people in your current life. Those can be people in the past, or even fictional characters, even people, you know, such as Oliver Twist or Harry Potter. You know, these great characters that are fundamentally survivors, resilient.
Absolutely. Great. So what I'd love for us to do is to experience a little bit of hypnosis, if that's something that you're okay to share with us.
Sure. So, you know, in this time, it's useful to recognize that, you know, there's some very, very good techniques. And what we can run through a very simple technique and recognize that hypnosis is simply working with that part of your mind which is instinctive, which is that part of your mind that automatically creates and maintains that experience unconsciously. And when we say unconscious mind, there is just all of you. So there's your conscious mind, there's your unconscious mind, but it's all one mind. But you do things unconsciously. You do things such as scratch your face, such as, you know, reach out to shake someone's hand, and then you go, oh, wow. You know, that's an unconscious pattern that we've done for so many times, so many years. And now we can't do that. And you'll notice how a lot of, you know, the rules are trying to change unconscious habits. So it's difficult, right? Because these are unconscious habits. So what we could do is really look at first relaxing the nervous system, because hypnosis is not relaxation, but it allows you to relax, access a profound sense of relaxation that your autonomic nervous system allows to happen. And when you do that, there is a part of your mind that allows learning to happen in a very instinctive, powerful way. And so we're going to look at a technique. How much time do we have, Emma?
Yeah, we've got time.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to consciously run through this technique, and then we're going to look at, in a way, installing this technique as something that you can use for yourself to deal with fear and anxiety. So this is called the AWARE technique. AWARE. AWARE. And AWARE is an acronym that stands for accept, watch, act as if, or act through, or act naturally, repeat, and expect the best. And we'll go through this, and Emma, you can just probably post this acronym also, so that people can have a visual representation of this. But accept what's happening to you. So, you know, if you've ever had a fear response, the more you resist it, the more it tends to persist. And it's kind of like quicksand. You're in an experience, you're having an emotional sort of, almost like a, if anybody's had a panic attack or had a very powerful anxiety experience, the resistance to it in that moment psychologically is kind of like quicksand. So the more you fight it, the deeper you go. The more you fight it, the deeper you go into your sunk. And so you want to simply accept what's happening to you. The W is for watch. And what that means is that you want to become the observer of your experience. You want to psychologically take a step back. To be able to change that experience, you need to be able to get some perspective internally in that situation. So watch, and in order to, you know, in order to do that, there are many things that you can do. One great thing that you can do is simply notice the sensations in your body, where that's showing up, And give it a number from 1 to 10. No. And often just that number, you say, oh wow, I'm feeling really nervous right now. On the scale of 1 to 10, that's about a 6. Just the act of doing that creates this psychological distancing. And you may find that even that begins to lower your anxiety. Excuse me. So the third letter, the third A in the AWARE acronym is ACT. Act through, act naturally, act as if. And in NLP, we use the as if frame, which is a very powerful thing where you know, some people call it fake it till you make it, but what it really is being able to embody the reality, the experience that you wish to be having. So recognizing that there's a part of your brain that has developed over millions of years to protect you from danger. If you're having anxiety in the moment of something that is physically not dangerous and it's over stimulating you, you have to send a powerful message to your mind and body that everything's okay. And, you know, in that moment, acting as if is using your body as a powerful signal to your instinctive mind that everything is fine. Walking confidently, holding your shoulders back, breathing deeply, sending that powerful message. There's even been studies that show that chewing gum reduces anxiety because it releases saliva. And, you know, the natural body's natural tendency is to conserve all our energy, right? So all of our resources are going to fighting, fleeing, or freezing, which is not very helpful, can be for certain animals. But a fight or flight. And so you have to conserve your energy, your sexual energy, your emotional energy, and your fluids, right? So if you chew gum, actually what it does is kind of stimulates that response, because people that are fighting and flying don't really eat, are not eating food, right? And so it's been proven to work. But that's acting as if, acting through, acting naturally. And then the R is for repeat. So it's repeat this process until you've the AWA part of the thing, until it becomes just natural to you, second nature, something that you can access internally and something that just becomes almost like a second thought. Ah, I'm having an experience. I'm accepting it, watching it, give it a number, shift my body, act through it, and just take action and move through, and you'll notice that your body naturally feels better. And that's a very powerful way to move forward. And then the E is for expect the best. So it's recognizing that things do tend to turn out for the best. There's a moment before an event where things are calm. There's a moment after an event where things are calm. And it's in the middle that you need to learn to calm right down. And you hold that positive outcome, tendency is that your body, your mind is going to help you create that reality for you, you know, if you want to use that language. So the AWARE technique is very powerful. It's helped thousands and thousands of people deal with panic attacks, anxiety, and so perhaps we can do a little bit of induction today. Do some relaxation and incorporate some of this.
That's wonderful. Thank you. Yeah, absolutely. I totally resonate with what you said about like when we're trying to resist something, that's when it just persists. And this is exactly what happened with me, because I got into NLP because I was experiencing panic attacks on a weekly basis. And I noticed that trying to control something, like trying to like manage and control something, I was like trying to force it. I was resisting actually feeling it and just allowing that energy and emotion to flow through me. And so it just kind of became bigger and bigger and bigger. So absolutely, like the awareness is really important, and that those steps that you just mentioned are really beneficial. Thanks.
Absolutely, absolutely. So what I do, I often do with my clients is, you know, I print out a card or I send them an infographic of this, and then just you have it on your phone so you can remind yourself of these steps. But what we'll do today is we'll just do a simple induction and have you experience this for yourself. So if it's okay with you, I'd like, you know, usually when before I do a live induction and do these sort of things, I say, you know, make sure you're not driving a car or operating heavy machinery. Now, if you're doing that, well, you know, that's not a good thing. That's a bad thing. So please do make sure that you're at home and make sure you won't be disturbed for this for about 15 minutes. So if you're listening to this, you know, on the recording afterwards, you know, make sure people are going to leave you alone for around 15 minutes as we do this particular induction. Okay.
Right.
So Emma, what I'm going to do, what I'd like you to do, if you can do this as well, is do mute yourself, and then I'll have you come back on just so we have good sound quality. So assuming that you are now in a place where you can relax and begin to allow your instinctive mind to learn new things in this moment, I invite you just to begin to make yourself comfortable. And you can sit in any way you'd like, but do making sure that your arms and legs are uncrossed. And it's preferable to sit in an upright position with your head comfortably supported. It's an attentive posture internally. And if you haven't closed your eyes, I'd like you to simply allow your eyes to close. And as you close your eyes now, and allow your mind to open to the possibility of experiencing something new here. And as you listen to the sound of my voice, and as you notice the surface supporting you comfortably, easily, naturally, and safely, just say hello to your body. Get in touch with your physical self. And it really isn't important for you to go all the way into a wonderful, comfortable, deep trance now. What's more important is that you simply allow yourself to begin to become curious about how one hand can feel heavier than the other. Perhaps your left hand feels warmer than your right hand, or your left feels warmer than what's right. Because as you focus on what's right, you leave what's left and go inside as my voice goes with you. And as every wonderful, comfortable breath allows that body to begin to enjoy comfort, not suggesting that you can simply drift into the deepest state of inner focus and rest immediately. It's far more enjoyable to allow yourself to find the right way for you to relax now. And as you can imagine that in this moment, deep, wonderful, powerful, comforting, warm relaxation begins to spread through that body. Perhaps noticing where in that body is already relaxed, is already deeply comfortable now. Well, that's right. And just allowing that relaxation to move through your experience like a beautiful light, calming. And it can be a wonderful color, like a calming blue or grounded orange, red. Safe here, as you listen to the sound of my voice, noticing your body there, as you listen to the sound of my voice, hear the sound of my voice as you go deeper and deeper. And from this moment forward, nothing bothers you, nothing disturbs you in any way. And I'd like you to imagine that from this moment forward, all the sounds around you, the sound of my voice, the experiences within you are simply signals for you to simply drift deeper and deeper, listening at the back of your mind as you allow yourself to rest. And quite probably, you've been having or have had certain thoughts, certain experiences, fear, certain imaginings. And that's okay. Because as you allow those thoughts to be as they are, you can sink into the space between the thoughts, almost like schools of fishes dancing, darting, playfully dancing in the deep blue sea, floating by. And you're here. You can just watch as you relax deeper and deeper. And even the very air around you can begin to relax now, transmitting supercharged rest and comfort into the cells of that body, which know how to enjoy peace, peace by inner peace, more than you consciously know how to do that now. Because as you continue listening to the sound of my voice, you can rest deeply. And you've been having certain thoughts. And from this moment forward, any time, when you find yourself in a situation where you've been having those old, unhelpful thoughts, those fears that send that mind racing, I'd like you to imagine bright and bold, vivid in front of you, the word aware. Almost like on an advertising billboard in front of you. Aware. And as you begin to see that now, the word aware. And the A stands for accept. Accept your experience. Yes, there is fear going on. Yes, you've been having an experience of fear. Something just about every human being from the beginning of time has experienced. You can accept the sensations, accept your emotions, accept where you are now as it is, as you relax deeper and deeper into the present. And the W stands for watch. And you can begin to take a step back inside, almost as if you could become the observer of your experience. Watch your experience, because it's one thing to be caught up in a storm, but it's quite another thing to be watching that storm way out at sea, way over there, as it blows itself out. As you're here, in the silence, watching. And A stands for act naturally. Because when you act confidently, when you breathe deeply, when you hold your body the way a person who's confident and has faith that things will work out, and you send that powerful message to your instinctive mind that you can handle things as and when they occur with those resources that you have. And R is for repeat. And as you repeat these steps, accepting your experience, watching your experience, and acting naturally, acting confidently, breathing deeply. The more you do that, the more that you know how things will work out for you. And E is for expect the best. Holding that powerful focus, that trust that life will work out for you. And you can imagine yourself now in a beautiful cinema, in a soft, comfortable seat, gazing up at a screen, comfortably looking up. And in a moment, not now, but in just a moment, I want you to see a film of you dealing with things confidently, naturally, easily in the coming days and weeks. Notice what that looks like. Notice that you dealing with challenges, taking really good care of yourself. Taking really, really good care of yourself, washing your hands repeatedly, keeping your hands to your sides, interacting with people with lots of distance, connecting with other people, doing those things that you know will make the difference, having a powerful sense of control in your life. Really see that now up there on that screen. Bright and bold and vivid. Notice how you flow through that day. Notice what you're doing. Perhaps noticing what it is about that you there that is different. Perhaps a gesture that indicates a sense of calm composure. Real confidence. And then I'd like you now to merge with that screen. Step into that and experience that for real from the inside now, from the beginning to the end. Flowing in powerful hypnotic time through that. See what you see, hear what you hear. Notice what you notice that's different. As you flow through that experience, seeing that film from the inside out now. All the way to the end where you know you've done everything to the best of your ability. And then you can just allow yourself to float back into the you here now, the sound of my voice as you go deeper and deeper. Integrating these learnings as an automatic template for how you will be acting, behaving in the days and the weeks and the months to come. And you can remember the aware sign, that powerful blue calming letters on an advertising billboard in front of you, aware, in bright blue letters. And now, I'd like you simply to thank yourself, thank your inner mind, thank all of you. It's a wonderful thing to invest your time, your energy in yourself like this, showing you that you matter, proving to yourself that your life matters, because it does. And in a moment, I'm going to invite you to just reorient your awareness back to the room. Bring all these learnings, this powerful aware technique, this powerful resource which you can carry with you, like a powerful talisman through the days that come. So just slowly beginning to reorient yourself to the room, coming back with a wonderful sense of good feeling. Just notice this surface that you're resting on. Take a deep breath in. And almost as if you're coming up through the clouds into the sunshine, bringing this good feeling with you. That's right. And just welcome back. And just center yourself. Welcome back.
Thank you very much for that. That was, yeah, I feel very calm and relaxed. And I'm sure those who are listening and joining in will feel the benefits now and also like after, well beyond after as well, the benefits will continue from that. So yeah, thank you for sharing that. That was really powerful.
Absolutely.
I feel like I'm floating. I'm super tranquil now.
That's right.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. So if people want to get in touch with you, how can they do that?
Hypnotherapyinbarcelona.com is my website. I've worked online since I started my practice, so since 2013. So I already see most of my clients online. So if people wish to work with me in any way, give me a shout, do get in touch, and we can also help you out with any challenges that you may be experiencing.
Great, wonderful. Yeah, and if people want to learn more about NLP as well, I share every week in the Facebook group Compassionate Inner Light. So that's where I am. I am. And there's more videos and things in there as well. So yeah.
Right. You have a Facebook page as well, another personal as well.
Yeah, so. Yeah. So there's a Facebook page, Emma Bradford. There's also a group, Compassionate Inner Lights.
Right.
And at the moment, because of the quarantine, we're not, oh, here I am touching my face. I just become aware of that. Because of the quarantine at the moment, because I have a meetup group, so because we're not able to meet up in person, the NLP meetups are currently Facebook Lives within the group. So if anyone wants to learn more about that, so yeah, do get in touch with either Ryan or myself if you're interested in more things.
Yeah.
And yeah, thank you for joining today, Ryan, and sharing everything that you have.
Thank you so much. You know, we get to stay inside and be safe and learn so much during this period. So it's really, really good.
Absolutely. There's so many opportunities to be embraced at the moment.
Absolutely.
Great. Yeah,
thanks. Thank you. Talk soon.
You're welcome. Thank you.